Hello everybody, I am Julie Gessen, a PhD student at UC Leuven in Belgium. In this presentation, I will show you a really powerful methodology to optimize the additive manufacturing parameters in order to get a part with a really high density, but also the best mechanical properties. I will apply this methodology to the aluminum silicon 12 pre-alloyed powder manufactured by laser powder bed fusion. In laser powder bed fusion, the coater will spread a layer of powder on the fabrication plate. Then the laser will selectively melt the powder, and so layer by layer after complete manufacturing of the part. Different LPBF parameters need to be optimized. Otherwise, the parts might contain some defect, such as porosity or cracking, which will lead to an early failure of the material. There are four main parameters to optimize. First, there is the laser power, which is the power of the laser. There is the speed at which the laser will scan the powder, the scanning speed. There is the distance between two tracks of laser, which is the hatching space. And finally, there is the layer thickness. These parameters need to be optimized for each new material on each new machine and for each granulometry. In this presentation, the layer thickness will be kept constant at 30 microns, and we will focus on the optimization of the three other parameters, so the laser power, hatching space, and scanning speed. For the moment, there is no real standard method to optimize the LPBF parameters. Some researchers manufacture cubes with many different combinations of power, scanning speed, and hatching space. Then, they measure the density of each cube, using, for example, Archimedes' method. And finally, they choose the parameters leading to the highest density. So, what do you think? Is it a good strategy? For me, I don't think it's a good strategy. Indeed, you might not find the optimal parameters if you don't try and manufacture and test this combination of optimal parameters. Moreover, it's really time-consuming and it's really expensive to manufacture all these cubes and then to analyze their density. I think that we can do better. Another strategy to decrease the amount of cubes to manufacture is to use a design of experiment. It will allow us to select the cubes that will be manufactured, analyzed, and then with all the results obtained, we can build a statistical model which will allow us to predict the density of every combination of LPBF parameters in the domain. Then we will be able to select the optimal parameters. What do you think of this strategy? It is already better than the first strategy. Indeed, it allows to find the optimal parameters and there are less cubes that need to be manufactured and analyzed. Therefore, we already decreased quite significantly the manufacturing time and cost. However, it's possible to further reduce this manufacturing time and cost. This is done by analyzing single scan tracks. The idea is that a part is made of the overlapping of single tracks. Therefore, the properties of the part strongly depend on the properties of each single track. This is why, instead of manufacturing cubes, we will actually manufacture single tracks and optimize their geometry. We will focus on the top view, so is the single track continuous? We want a single track which is continuous, and also on the cross section here. For this, we need enough cohesion with the previous layer. We need also to have a sufficient height. And we need an angle which is closest as possible to 90 degrees to have a good accuracy of the manufacturing. So for this, we will only focus on two parameters, so the laser power and the scanning speed. Indeed, the hatching space is the distance between two single tracks, but as we analyze only one, there is no hatching space in this case. So let's resume our optimization problem. So what we want to do is to answer to this question. So what are the values of the LPBF parameters that optimize the single scan track geometry, the porosity, and the mechanical properties of the global aluminium silicon 12 part. For that, we can play on three factors: the laser power, the scanning speed, and the hatching speed. Then we will analyze the results of three responses. So the single scan track geometry, the global porosity of the part, and the mechanical properties. And to optimize these parameters, we will use a response surface method, which is also called RSM, to evaluate the significance and the influence of the LPPF parameters on the quality of the part. We have built a methodology based on the analysis of single scan tracks using design of experiment. The goal of this methodology is to optimize not only the density, but also the mechanical properties of the part. If you want more details about this methodology, don't hesitate to go through our publication in Materials and Design. It's an open access publication. So, the first thing to check is to check the literature. This will allow you to decide which boundaries you will select for the laser power and the scanning speed. For example, in our case, we can find in the literature that we need at least a power of 150 watts to be able to manufacture dense aluminium parts due to the high reflectivity of the aluminium. Therefore, we have a lower boundary for the laser power, which is 150. Then we know that the limitation of the machine is 270 watts, so the boundaries for the laser power will be between 150 and 270 watts. Based on these boundaries, you will be able to build your design of experiment. Here, it's a central composite design. So a central composite design, it's a design which is actually a response surface methodology. It means that it's a statistical and mathematical tool which will allow you to build a model between the parameters and the response in order to optimize the response. So we use central composite design really when the goal is to optimize. So if you want optimization, you use this kind of design. Then you can see that the model is actually divided in three parts. The first part consists in manufacturing single scan tracks and analyzing their geometry. Based on this result, we will be able to create a mathematical model between the LPPF parameter, laser power, and scanning speed, and the track geometry. Then, the second step consists of manufacturing cubes, analyzing their density using Archimedes method, and then again create a mathematical model between the parameters and the density. Finally, we will manufacture a tensile specimen. We do the tensile test, and then we create again a mathematical model which will predict the mechanical properties in function of the parameters. After this, we will combine all these three models and select the optimal parameters. So first, let's focus on the single scan tracks. The single scan tracks were manufactured based on the design of experiments. Now it's time to analyze them, and we can see that we have four different types of tracks. When the energy is too low, we have what we call a bowling track. It means that the surface tension is really high, and so the liquid will actually take the shape of some droplets. The track is not continuous, and it's really not deep enough. We don't have enough cohesion with the previous layer, which means that this is really not the type of track that we want. If we increase the energy, the temperature in the melt pool increases, and so the surface tension. This allows to have deeper tracks, a good cohesion with the previous layer, and a track which is continuous. We can also see that the angle is close to 90 degrees, which is really what we want to obtain as a single track geometry. If we further increase the energy, instability starts to appear and the track becomes irregular. And finally, if we increase too much the energy, we have a transition from conduction to T-hole mode, which starts, and we obtain a really deep track and really porous. So that's really not what we want. So what we want is to obtain a stable track. Now, to show you the design of experiments are really interesting, I have compared a central composite design, which is the design of experiment which is proposed in the methodology, with a full factorial design. This consists of trying and analyzing all the combination of LPBF parameters. So this is actually 105 experiments, so we assume that this should give a more accurate model compared to a central composite design, which is based on only 9 experiments. So let's compare their results. Based on the geometrical features of the single scan tracks, we could build a mathematical model using an ANOVA and logistic regressions. On the left, you can see the model based on the central composite design, so 9 experiments, while on the right, you can see the model obtained based on the full factorial design, so based on 105 experiments. In red, you can see all the parameters leading to non-continuous tracks, so bowling tracks, meaning that the energy there is too low to have a stable track. In blue, we can see all the parameters leading to a ratio of depth over total height of the track, which is not suitable, meaning that either the track is too deep, either it's not deep enough. Then we have the dotted area, which is composed of the parameters where the contact angle is too low. The white area, which is neither red, neither blue, neither dotted, is actually all the combination of parameters leading to suitable track geometry. It can be seen that the process window obtained based on the central composite design is actually 85% similar to the one based on 105 experiments, meaning that with only 9 experiments, we have already a good accuracy, we have already a good overview of the process window, and we can win a lot of time with this. For the following of the presentation, I will continue with the central composite design, and I will not talk about the full factorial design anymore. Now that we have done this with this single track, for the methodology, you will have to continue the same with the cubes. You analyze the density and then again you build a mathematical design. The trick here is that you don't have only 2 parameters anymore, you need to add the hatching space. If the hatching space is too large, you can see that you can have some unmelted region between 2 tracks. So you need to adjust the hatching space to have enough overlapping. Finally, for the third step, tensile specimens are manufactured, the mechanical properties are analyzed, and again, as for the single scan tracks and the cubes, a mathematical model which predicts the mechanical properties in function of the LPBF parameters is built. Now it's time to take all this mathematical model and put them together. The 3 statistical models are now grouped together and the desirability criteria is set here. So we want the highest mechanical properties, we want a high density and good geometry of the single scan tracks. So as you can see, it's still here in red the parameters combination which leads to non-continuous single scan tracks, in blue the combination of parameters which leads to ratio of depth over total height of the single tracks, which does not satisfy the desirability criteria. But in addition, we also have here in orange, these are all the parameters which have a density smaller than 99%, here the same. And we also have here the line in gray, it's all the parameters which have a yield strength which is too low. And finally, so in white, these are all the combination of parameters which satisfy the desirability criteria. So we can select the parameters of interest. Now, to confirm the model, the prediction of the models here were compared to experimental data for one new combination of parameters. So as you can see, the predictions are in agreement with the experimental data. It's very similar. Now, let's compare the mechanical properties obtained with our optimized parameters with the one reported in the state-of-the-art literature. We can clearly see that the mechanical properties obtained with our optimization methodology leads to higher mechanical properties than in the other literature. In conclusion, the optimum LPPF parameters have been established for aluminium silicon 12 based on an efficient and cost-effective methodology. Then, we could see that 9 single scan tracks identifies a process window which is 85% similar to the one resulting from a full factorial design with 105 single scan tracks. We also have seen that the optimal LPPF parameters leads to higher mechanical properties than the one reported in the literatures. And finally, the statistical model prediction for the density and the mechanical properties were validated experimentally for one new combination of optimized LPPF parameters.